online reviews before you make a big church purchase or book a vacation. Sorry to break it to you, they're not always on the up and up.
So how do you know when a review is reliable, and what are the red flags to watch out for? Sharon Epperson is CNBC's personal finance correspondent, and she's with us. Good to see you.
Sure. Good to be here.
Okay, so you admitted last night doing this segment, getting ready for it, and you got anxiety from it.
Yeah, there's just so much to go through, so many different reviews, but a lot of folks out there, one study out today showing that 90% of customers are going to believe the online reviews and trust them even more than personal recommendations.
And this can have a huge impact on a small business, any business, a restaurant. You get a couple bad reviews at the top of that list and it can bury you.
It can bury you. And if you have positive reviews, it's more likely the person's going to trust the business and go to your business. You know, there was one study that came out by Harvard researchers that showed that just an one-star rating, an increase of one star for a Yelp review of a restaurant, could increase revenues by 5 to 9%.
Wow. So it's tough to figure out who to believe, but we reached out to some of the major sites to see what's reliable, what's fake, what's biased, and how they weed those out. Let's start off with Yelp, since you mentioned them.
Yeah, Yelp, you know, you find a lot of restaurant reviews. There's local businesses. They have about 57 million reviews, so how do you know which ones to go through? They do some of the work for you, and they actually have some special recommendation software that they use. They look at IP addresses and email addresses to figure out which ones so that they know a little bit about the reviewer that they're telling you is a recommended review. To find the ones that are not recommended, you have to go all the way to the end of the posting to a special link to find those.
Okay, how about Amazon? That's another big one people go to.
Oh, a lot of people go there to see the reviews for certain products. And a lot of things that you may want to purchase, you want to make sure that someone else has purchased them. So they have a verified purchase label on some of the reviews, and that way you know that that reviewer actually has the product that you want.
TripAdvisor, they have more than 150 million reviews.
That's a lot. And millions and millions of people go there to sift through their site, too, to find the best reviews. They have algorithms. They have 200 what they call content specialists to go through the reviews to make sure that they're legitimate reviews. And they say that according to their own research, about 95% of the people that use TripAdvisor believe that what they read on those reviews is accurate based on their experience.
Well, it's good those companies have policies, but you've got to do a little homework yourself
you
as well. So where do you begin with that?
Well, you start with the reviewer. I mean, some of these sites are checking out the reviewer, but you want to do your own research and look to see where do they come from? What kind of reviews have they posted in the past? Do they have some of the similar interests that I have to make sure that what they're saying really jives with what you want to do?
You say also read at least a dozen reviews.
Well, TripAdvisor says a lot of their customers do that already, but you want to read about that many on several different sites, compare different types of sites to see what review makes sense to you.
How about the history of reviews? What does that mean?
Well, you know, some reviews might have been 2 or 3 years old. Since then, the hotel could have had a facelift. The restaurant could have totally changed their menu. So you want to make sure you're looking at the most current reviews.
Good point. And what about the language of the review itself?
So a lot of people want to know what's the red flag to see if maybe someone's getting paid to write a review. Maybe it's a blog or something. Sometimes they'll use similar wording on several different review sites about the same place. That might be a red flag that perhaps this person is getting something in return for writing these reviews.
I've got to ask you quickly, too, about doctors and specialists. More and more people going online and trusting what they read. That's a very delicate issue.
It is a very delicate issue, but if you want to just find out what the office is like or what the personality of the doctor is like, maybe that's a good place to go. But if you want to find out whether they're board certified, their education, all of those things, you want to check with the government website, with the state medical board.
Good stuff, Sharon. Thank you
sure.
so much.
Thanks, Sharon.